Nature makes no distinctions. Nature, the greatest researcher, has never made gender distinction in the evolution of species. Scientific research, this great artificial machine, can't escape from this natural law. Women have always contributed to scientific research. Every time that a woman fights for herself, she fights for all women. Equality is the soul of freedom. There isn't, in fact, any freedom without it. Women have always had to fight twice. Women have always had to carry two weights, the private and the social. Women are the backbone of society. Women who changed the world never needed to show anything other than their intelligence. Overcome prejudice. We are building our future like them, for a possible career as researchers. From the opposable thumb to the robotic hand. Tetrapods have five fingers at the end of the arm, but the first paws belong to Tetrapodophis. One of them is the Acanthostega, which had eight fingers, while the Ichthyostega had seven of them. The development of the hand's anatomy starts with the zebrafish and ends with the human structure, passing by other species. The ox genes control this development and the growth of the number of fingers, with the regulation of their expression. The expression of the genes is controlled by a series of enhancers, DNA sequences. In tetrapods, the expression of OXA9 and OXA13 is in the distal part, the future hand, and the expression of OXA11 is only in the proximal part. In fish, OXA11 is expressed with OXA13. What is the cause of the change in the expression of ox genes? The limitation of the OXA11 is due to a particular genetic sequence. The responsibility falls on the RNA regulator called long non-coding RNA. Where the RNA is expressed, there is no OXA11, so there are fingers. Scientists have proved that OXA13 and OXD13 are necessary to form five fingers. An abnormal presence of OXA11 and OXD11 in the distal part will cause a hand with seven fingers. So, the absence of OXA11 in the distal part is necessary for the formation of only five fingers. In the zebrafish, RNA regulator doesn't exist, so it probably was essential for ants evolution. And after billions of years, the opposable thumb. In the Australopithecus africanus, 3.2 million years ago, we can find the metacarpal quite like the human's one, and 2.4 million ago, Homo habilis had the same ability to take objects. This comparison proves that even the Australopithecus could take objects rather than what the scientists thought. Today, after studying the ant evolution, humans create artificial hands for people who have lost theirs. One example is the robotic hand, created by the Prosthesis Center of the Italian Institute of Technology, which helps to recover 19% of functionality of the real hand. We too made a robotic hand in our school, the first step for our scientific career for humanity. For the realization of this robotic hand, we had to acquire various skills, including the 3D modeling, used to make the skeleton of our digital hand, and then make it seem like real through the use of the 3D printers in our school. Another fundamental step for the realization of this project was undoubtedly the programming through Arduino. And with the use of 5 servomotors and 5 flexion sensors, have allowed our hand to come to life.